Yeah. Okay, hold on. Hey you guys, also Sean here. I am here to do Chingy. I don't know if y'all remember Chingy or not. Uso. I know my brothers and sisters and we was crazy about Chingy now. Now I don't know if my brother was a fan of Chingy, but I know us sisters, we was a very fan of Chingy because Chingy is a nice looking black man. Yeah, so I'm not gonna use my marker because the details on here is quite small. But what I am going to do is just get a good picture of it. I am going to use the Premier Color Black. Now, when you're dealing with Premier Color, you have to be very, very careful because it will smudge. So, let me sharpen it and then get to tracing. Okay, so yeah. And if you had to rest like me, it's not gonna come up straight. That's okay though. I was going to put like all the details of the background and stuff in the picture, but then I said that's too much work, so I just left in like a camera and stuff in the picture. on those scarf, you can just put down any zigzag lines on there. It really doesn't make a difference. Because it's gonna take a lot of work anyway as it is. Yeah, you don't have to put down specific details. Happy early Thanksgiving. It's almost time for Thanksgiving. Tomorrow is Wednesday. In my household, we get started early. We start cooking early because when Thursday comes, we just want to eat and enjoy ourselves. We don't want to do nothing on Thanksgiving because Thanksgiving is a holiday. And we just want to enjoy ourselves. That's it. And don't worry about being specific on the hands details because I didn't feel like the hands was really important. I just didn't, you know. But eventually I will do a video about tracing out different types of hands. I had to draw plenty of hands and fingers and stuff, you know. It's just right now I'm on time limit and I don't have much time, so yeah. So we got that all traced out. I'm playing my audio book because I'm happy about Thanksgiving.
done. Think of a wet roof at sunset.
It's the audiobook for First Man on the Moon for H.D. Wells. So let's go and get started. First thing first, I'm going to go and work on his skin complexion. Chingy. I'm going to use yellow and my favorite color, brown. Oh, this ain't my favorite color, brown. This is right here, but let me see, yellow. Shoot with this one. I think I'm going to use this, my favorite color, toasted toffee. And I'm going to shove in it too, so I'm going to shove in my...
Yes, they would have carried us over that bridge. Yes, they must have carried us from outside. I'd rather be carried by a fly across a ceiling. Good heavens. I resumed my destruction of the bungee. And suddenly I
both of the pencils that I'm using... Oh, crazy art. I'm trying not to smudge the picture too. Because it will try to smudge on you. I put a yellow on first. Yeah, yellow. Now I'm going to use the toasted toffee.
Okay, so
I think I might, well, I'll do that last, but I want to fill in his skin some more and shaving. Before I do that, I want to put in his little mustache and his little beard. It's a Crayola brown also. And I'm trying to do some shaving. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna get the crazy art white and go certain parts of his face with it. Okay, so now I'm gonna get the gold right here. don't have much of it. But this is the premier art goal. And try not to smudge the picture once again. Try not to smudge it. Get this sunflower and go over certain parts of his face. Okay, so now I'm gonna get my crazy art white, and I'm gonna blend his skin complexion out with it. Try not to smudge the picture. Always remember not to smudge the picture. I need to sharpen this.
After a time, the first violence of our efforts diminished, and our movements became more deliberate and less painful. The noise of the pursuing selenites had died away altogether. It seemed almost as though they had not traced us up the crack after all, in spite of the telltale heap of broken fungi that must have lain beneath it. At times, the cleft narrowed so much that we could scarce squeeze up it. And others had expanded into great druzy cavities, studded with prickly crystals, or thickly beset with dull, shiny fungoid minerals. Sometimes it twisted spirally, and other times slanted down nearly to the horizontal direction. Ever
Okay, so I got that down with Chingy. Next, then go the eyebrow. Next step, ears. Let me see. Let's do his hat. So, this is black on the hat. This is gray on the hat. Now, I didn't put no details down because I didn't feel like doing all that. So, let's go get started. Okay, so I'm gonna put the gray on. Like I said, if you want to add in some details, you can. But I don't have time for the details. So. Now I'm going to use the scarf was black, this is white. Black, black, white, white. So don't fill in the white spots, just leave it like you used. I'm going to put this right here, this sideburn. Now I have made the sideburn larger in the picture. I don't know why. But I did because I can. That's the bottom line, because I can. And I don't know, I think it's cute. Now I'm gonna go over it with this crazy art white. I don't know. Hello? I guess so. I don't know, Diane. I mean, you won't know till you try. I'm drawing right now. But I'm gonna use my crazy art black. I had already said to them that I am doing my cartoon, but I think my sister and my brother want some attention. Side by side in the depression, peering over the edge of the cavern and its occupants.
was a much larger cavern than we had supposed from our first glimpse of it, and we looked up from the lowest portion of its sloping floor. It widened out as it receded from us, and its roof came down and hid the remoter portion altogether. And lying in a line along its length, vanishing at last far away in that tremendous perspective, were a number of huge shapes, huge pallid hulls.
Okay, so now.
At first, they seemed
this right here, and that it's kind of like an off color black in a way, gray like. I'm gonna go over the scars with this. To make a difference, it's kind of like a brown, black, and not for sure.
Some way away, a thing like a trolley came, drawn and loaded with chunks of black meat, was running up the slope of the cavern floor. This enormous long avenue of hulls that were destined to be food gave us a sense of the vast populousness of the moon world, second only to the effect of our first glimpse down the shaft. It seemed to me at first that the Selenites must be standing on trestle-supported planks. Then I saw that the planks and supports and the hatchets were really of the same leaden hue as my fetters had seen.
And now I'm going to use this black. I'll go over again with this black. I need shoveling.
They were perhaps 6 feet long, with shade dandles. Tempting-looking weapons. The whole place was lit by three transverse streams of the blue fluid. I do not remember seeing any wooden things on the moon. Doors, tables, everything corresponding to our terrestrial joinery was made of metal, and I believe for the most part of gold, which as a metal would, of course, naturally recommend itself, other things being equal, on account of the ease in working it and its toughness and durability. Lay for a long time noting all these things in silence. Well, said Kapoor at last. I crouched over and turned to him. I had come upon a brilliant idea. Unless they lowered those bodies by a crane, I said, it must be nearer the surface than I thought. Why? The moon calf doesn't hop, and it hasn't got wings. We peered over the edge of the hollow again. I wonder now, he began. After all, we have never gone far from the surface. I stopped him by a grip on his arm. I had heard a noise from the cliff below us.
Okay, so.
About and lay as still as death, with every sense alert. In a little while, I did not.
Now I'm gonna do his shirt. The black around his shirt.
Very slowly and quite noiselessly, I assured myself. Something to appear. Just look at those chaps with the hatchets again, I said. They're all right, said Kapoor. I took a sort of provisional aim at the gap in the grating. I could hear now quite distinctly the soft twittering of the ascending Selenites, the dab of their hands against the rock, and the falling of dust from their grips as they clambered. Then I could see that there was something moving dimly in the blackness below the grating.
The microphone. I'm pressed on it, but as I go up, I'm make it a little lighter. Like that.
But when you flashed out at me, it was the key point of a spear. I have thought since that its length and the narrowness of the cleft must have prevented its being slowed to reach me. Anyhow, it shot out from the grating like the tongue of a snake, and missed, and flew back and flashed again. For the second time, I snatched and caught it, and wrenched it away, but not before another had darted ineffectually at me. I shouted with triumph as I felt that the hold of the Selenite resist my bolt for a moment and give. As I was jamming down through the bars, amid squeals from the darkness, and Kapoor had
snapped off the other spear. Now let's work on the microphones and everything.
Clank,
Let's put some gray on here. This is crazy awkward. Crazy art blood and go over there. Put something around the chain too. Okay, so
with each, the game opened out, and the number of cells.
and take the crazy I want dream and put it right here. Move this out my way so I can see what I'm doing. And let's see. Let's see. Now I'll take the crazy off black. So I'm gonna use this crazy out white and I'm gonna go over with the crazy. Shut. Dang. Fuck over here. Get the crazy off the back, go over here. Now we'll use this a premier color white. Now I get the craze out by again. Crazy, I agree. Crazy art, but crazy out white. This is why I didn't want to put in a lot of details, because it takes a lot of work, you know. Gonna work on this woman here. But before I do that, I almost forget. Now let's work on her hands. Her fingers, yeah. I'm thinking about the color. I'm going to use the Premier Color Peach on, you know, certain parts of her hand. But just like on the side, like, and then put a little bit of this sunflower on it too. And it is strange that Now I'm going to fill it in the fingers, man. Now I'm going to get my toasted toffee, lightly blend it on there. Take my premier color white and go over it, lay it out. Okay, and next thing I am going to do is the ring. The ring she had on looked like it was gray and white, so put this gray down. Now I'm going to put the white on the corner. Get the crazy art white. And his earring. Oh, and his little red right there too. I forgot about that. And now I gotta do Chingy lips. I'm gonna use deep raspberry on his lip. I'm lightly put it on his lip. And now I can go back over there with some brown. Take a little bit of this red hot and lightly. Now I'm going to use the premier color, not the premier color, but the crazy art white.
Nearly 10. Do you know the sun is past its zenith, and those things are different. Everything is different. Everything. To me, it seems that since first we came out of the sphere, it's been only a question of hours, long hours at most.
And I am finished with my Chingy picture. Oh, one more thing. I almost forget. This is the Crazy RG Raspberry. Crazy Art White. Okay. I am finished with my Chingy picture. Hope you guys enjoyed it.